One of the beautiful things about wristwatches is that just like humans, they come in all different kind of colors, shapes and sizes. And one of the watches that I really, really, really have been looking forward to is the Certina DS PH200 meter water resistant diver. So this is a remake of a dive watch that Certina released back in 1967. I've got this watch on my mind and my brain since the Baselworld 2018 watch fair where this watch was introduced. And so Certina released it this November 2018. And finally, I was able to get this price, this watch at a very nice price. And I must say, it's just such an enjoyable dive watch. So very quickly about the history of this watch. Originally, it was introduced in 1967 as a very water-resistant watch. Back then, 200 meters of water resistance was very, very nice. Automatic movement and a screw-down crown with the double security system, the DS system from Certina. So fast forward many years, the watch is re-released with new materials, a nice movement, and it also is beefed up a bit in size. So the original was just around 40 millimeters in diameter. This watch is 42.8 millimeters in diameter. And there's things about this watch making it wear a little bit bigger than the almost 43 millimeters. And on the other hand, it actually wears a little bit smaller, which I will get into later in this review. So what we have is an automatic dive watch, as you can see here. So it's powered by the Powermatic 80 movement. So the Powermatic 80 movement is an ETA movement. It's an ETA, basically an ETA 2824-2, but they modified it quite heavily. So you get a power reserve of 80 hours. The price you pay is that the beat rate is a little bit lower. It's approximately 25,000 beats per hour and not 28,800 beats per hour. So you can see the second hand here, it beats a little slower, but on the plus side, you get 80 hours of power reserves. All power reserves from the 2824, like 38 to 42 hours, it's simply not enough today. You have to go beyond 60 hours and even more. So you see the new Rolex and Tudor watches, they are 60 to 70 hours of power reserve. And that's a big plus with this watch. So if you follow my channel, you would know I unboxed this watch very recently. And if you want to see the absolutely amazing packaging this watch comes in, you can click the card up here in the right corner or follow the link down below after you have seen this review. And then you will see the amazing packaging this watch comes in. So it comes in a very nice box with a spare nasal strap. And later in this review, during this review, I'm going to show you how it looks on the nasal strap. So the dimensions, as I mentioned, is almost 43 millimeters in diameter. So you get just short of 43, including the crown, which is very nice and big and easy to operate, is 46. The thickness is a very nice, just approximately 13 millimeters. And we get a very nice lug width of 20 millimeters. This watch is a strap monster, which you will see when I show you how it looks on the NATO strap. But I think I prefer it on this very nice brown leather strap. It comes on, as you can see, I needed to punch another hole because it's actually more fitted to larger wrist sizes than mine. And we get 50 millimeters of lock-to-lock distance. So before we get more into the review of this watch, a quick wristwatch check. So I'm wearing the Spinnaker Bradner, which is another vintage-inspired dive watch I'm going to review very soon. But back to the Certina. So what we get is a 60-click bezel, which is very, very tooly. It's very industrial. It's not very gliding. It's very metallic and clicking. And listen to the sound. So with modern dive watches, you often see 120 click bezels, but with this one, you get 60, which is perfectly fine. So not many people are actually going to use this as a professional dive watch, and you can't actually, unless you put it on another strap, because this strap will be destroyed in water and the nasal strap will also be worn out in water. So it is a disc diver watch. So what they opted to do with this very nice vintage inspired domed crystal is actually using a plastic crystal. So acrylic crystal on this one, hessalite, and not sapphire crystal. So this might be a letdown for a lot of people. I know a lot of people, they definitely prefer to have a sapphire crystal on a modern watch, but I actually enjoy the fact that they used a hessalite crystal. It brings down the weight just a little bit, but it, when you touch it, you get this very nice vintage feel with the crystal. A sapphire crystal just feels completely different and more modern than hessalite crystal. So when we look closer on the dial, let me just see if it can zoom. So Certina automatic at below 12 o'clock, the Certina logo. DS PH200 meter water resistant, Swiss made here, above, below and above 6 o'clock. You get a date window. Let me just try to unscrew the very nice signed big non-guarded crown, which I also really enjoy. For my sake, they could easily have left out the date window, because a vintage dive watch isn't about which day it is. It's actually all about timing and having accurate time and very legible time. So you can see we have very nice sword hands, very big, very loom filled. I will pull up a loom shot now. So amazing loom with this Swiss super lumino that they applied to the DS PH200 watch here. Also, I really like the red crosshair and how it plays with the red seconds hand. So I think the design is just super, super cool with this watch. I really enjoy it. It's aluminium, so it's quite prone to scratches, but you didn't use ceramic back in the 60s. So you use aluminium. As you can see, the dial is just slightly kind of domed inside, and it has this glossy look to it, which also looks very nice. It looks very modern, but it also looks very vintage. So the case finishing is absolutely beautiful. So of course, no polishing, because it is a vintage inspired dive watch. So you want a very truly industrial look, very simple case design with lugs just sloping down, which makes the watch wear much better on your wrist. But very, very beautiful brushing, as you can see here. It's amazing work with the brushing, and it looks just beautiful. Very nice coinage and easy to grip on this big bezel, which actually just protrudes the case here. So a very beautiful thing as well with this watch is definitely the case back. So you got the old Certina DS Turtle logo, which I think looks absolutely amazing on this watch. You get all the information here, Certina, 200 meters, all the different 20 bar, water resistant and stainless steel, which is of course 316L stainless steel, which is the proprietary and most used type of steel for dive watches. It's quite scratch resistant, and it doesn't rust in water. So a very beautiful thing about this watch is definitely the case back. I think they did an amazing job with the case back. So a nice thing with the strap, the leather strap here, is that it comes with quick removal pins. So it's very easy just to take this off, and then you get another set in the box. So you just put in the new spring mask, and then you put on the NATO strap. So let me show you how it looks on the NATO strap. So as you can see, the NATO strap actually makes the watch wear a little bit bigger. So it's all up to you if you want to have this watch wear a little bit bigger. It's up to your wrist size, but I think I can pull it off with my wrist of approximately 18 centimeters, which is approximately 7 inches. So here on my 18 centimeter wrist, you can see it definitely doesn't wear too big. It's all about not having the lugs go beyond your wrist, and it doesn't, and I think it wears very comfortable. It is a very light watch, definitely also because of the hessalite crystal, because it's not sapphire, so it's lighter. And I really like it on this leather strap with this nice, beautiful signed pin buckle here. Very nice leather strap. It has this kind of cafe latte, almost brown color, and the stitching here just gives it this very vintage look, and I just really want to enjoy this strap and wear the hell out of it so it looks even more worn. So this watch retails at approximately $650 and $750 brand new, and I think you get one hell of a nice watch for that amount of money. It's definitely a quality watch. You buy into a very nice piece of Swiss dive watch history with modern touches, with the amazing Powermatic 80 movement, the beautiful design. You get a dive watch which is definitely very different to what you see on a lot of wrists today. So I think you get a very special watch. I definitely enjoy this watch, and I'm pretty sure this is a definite keeper in my collection because it's just such a fun watch to wear, and it's so different. And I like how you really get a vintage watch with modern materials and a modern movement. This is also a quite accurate watch. I get approximately 5 to 6 seconds plus a day, which is definitely amazing. It's just within COSC specifications, so that's very, very nice from Certina to make this watch as accurate as it is. So I hope you enjoyed this review of the Certina DS PH200 vintage inspired dive watch, brand new 2018 release. Remember to follow me on Instagram and Facebook, give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this review, leave a comment down below, subscribe to my channel, and I will definitely be back with many more watch reviews, and of course also a review of the Spinnaker you saw me wear earlier in this video. Thank you, bye.